Okay.
I've got four of them on, four of the seat slats. And I thought I would show you how I put the last one on. And basically, I just use these blocks that were scraps from chair legs. And I use those for a spacer. And I've got the holes pre-drilled here. And I just put four screws in. Sink my screws so it'll be flush. And that's that. And you have, you see, chair seat completed. Now, the next thing to do is build the back. Okay, what I'm going to show you right now is how to build the back. And the back's a little bit tricky. The first thing you want to do is cut your piece that goes underneath of the last seat slat. You want to kind of do a test fit. That it doesn't really matter the distance, just that it fits, and it's eventually going to go right up in here and be screwed right through on the top and the sides. So you want to make sure that that piece right there will fit in here. Then it's just a simple matter of cutting the stock to go on the for the back. And I found these are the five pieces we'll make the back slats. I make mine 32 inches long, the center three, because that's 8 foot without any waist, cut twice. And then the two outside pieces are about 30 inches. And I found the easiest way to do this is to just set the outside two first. And screw them down. And then just start evenly spacing center pieces. And you just kind of have to work that out. There's no real set spacing. I just set the two outside and then divide evenly my distance. And generally it works out to, I don't know, 7/8 of an inch or something, 3/4, somewhere in there. So no more than an inch apart. I'm going to say these are going to be like 3/4 of an inch. And then just screw those down. I make a little triangle pattern with my screws. Then I go up here and put the cross piece for the attachment with the arms. And generally it measures right at 16 inches from the bottom. So that's what I'm going to do right now. And it does help to level these up, to put a piece of scrap out here to get them level and just hold them up and screw them in. So that's what I'm going to do. Alright, got the back assembled, and now I'm going to put the cross piece on that kind of holds it all together and attaches the back to the arm. And this piece needs to be placed the bottom of it at 16 inches from the bottom of the back. And I like to leave mine whatever the width of the back is. This one measures 21. I cut this piece 25. So I'd have about 2 inches sticking out on each side to attach the arms with. And best thing to do is go ahead and just set your two outside pieces pretty quickly, or pretty easily, and then just adjust the rest of your pieces inside, and you just want to center them up best you can. Just make sure the distances are even. And get one in all of them so you can hold them. Use your spacers to make sure it's kind of squared up. Screw in. Alright, and there you got the back. I'm going to put a couple more screws in it, but that's pretty much it. Okay, what I'm getting ready to show you is the attachment of the back and the chair seat. I've tried this many ways, and what I found works the best is just to get something to set the back on to kind of hold the weight, and then clamp it so it don't fall an inch in the head. But what I do is just kind of set the back up and get it flushed up, and then run a couple screws in it. Then you can let your clamp off, and the back is in place. I can put three in the back, what I'm doing is I'm driving those screws through the back into the back seat slat, and you might have to, when you're wedging the back in there, you might have to, I had to hit it with a hammer twice just to get it in there. But as long as you've measured it pretty close, it should go right in. Then I'm going to show you how I attach on the end over here. You'll notice one of those screws is a little bit longer. I like to put one good long screw in there just to kind of support the weight of the back. Now you gotta remember the arms are gonna be holding the back up as well. But I put four screws in it. And what you're doing is you're just screwing the into the back from the side over here. And I'm just hitting those pieces of the back. And this is plenty of support for anything this chair is designed to do. So that one good long screw should hold that. And then you just do the same thing on the other side. Okay, what we're getting ready to do right now is put the arm on. And I have already cut, I think you can can see that the arm at 24 degrees to match the back. And what I'm doing now is I'm going to put the arm on and get it level and mark where level it'll be. And then I want to set a distance out here at the end, about 3/4 inch past, and I'm just gonna cut this off square and attach the arm. Alright, and what I'm gonna do now is attach the arm to the back. And to do this, I like to use these longer screws to make sure the back stays on there. So I just use these 3-inch screws and attach the arm to the back. Put another screw here, another one in the back, so a total of 4, and probably a cleat underneath the front of the arm, and do that on the other side, and that'll pretty much be it. Alright, what I'm going to do right now is mark the back with our little homemade compass here, and this is going to cut our arc. All we gotta do is cut that out with the jigsaw, and we've got the arc of the back of our chair cut. Alright, on that other video, somehow I deleted the footage of the last chair I was building when I was rounding the back, but this works the same way on this treated chair, so I just finished this and cut the back. Now I marked it with my homemade compass, and now I'm gonna cut the back off, and you wanna make sure you measure your two chairs and make sure your arc is the same length. So here we go. Find the midpoint in the middle of the arm, and then cut enough to where the center of your hole saw will miss the leg. So for these chairs, it's 6 1/4 back and 2 3/4 in. You want to be real careful when you're doing this, because this thing can kick a little bit. Holder, and just put a piece of scrap block underneath of it and screw it in, and you'll have the cup holder.